tomorrow's show. We will be there. We will take with us, of course, millions of eyes, the eyes of the world, which will be upon Atlanta this week, guys, for Rams Patriots Super Bowl 53.
Can't wait.
We love New York. Ah! Let's get to Atlanta. I want there. I want to get to that stadium. Place looks like it's from Cybertron. It's amazing. Let's go.
Let's do it. Let's
and it will go. Be there all week. It'll be long hours. But even people who landed yesterday, Shregs, all weekend, I already have like the FOMO. I'm like, why are we not there already?
Good call.
Setting up. They have their feet on the ground. I want to get there.
Yeah, and I want to wear what Wade Phillips wore yesterday on the jet.
Look out. Oh, goodbye. Oh, I want to wear that, baby.
There's a certain look to come into the Super Bowl, and Wade Phillips has perfected it.
It's a pretty good look you got on, though.
I feel
though,
pretty
today,
good,
though.
But I ain't Wade.
You ain't Wade.
I ain't the son of Bull.
Nate Kyle Brent. My name's Kay Adams, and it's time for the lead block.
Lead block!
Lead block.
We're feeling some of that FOMO, and we're not there in Atlanta. We have reporters who are James Palmer with the Patriots at their hotel, Tom Pelissero from the Rams hotel. So let's kick things off with James and these Pats, their third straight trip to the Super Bowl. Does that give them an advantage this week leading up?
Okay, this isn't Minneapolis right now, but I will tell you, it's 30 degrees here in Atlanta, 1 degree warmer than it is in Foxborough. Patriots last week practiced at their indoor facility. We'll move to the indoor facility at Georgia Tech this week, about a mile from this team hotel. And the preparation that we bring up is what they wanted to accomplish last week was finding that balance and how much they put on these players' plate. Offensive coordinator Josh McDaniels said the only comparison you can have preparing for this game is preparing really for the first game of the regular season, where you have so much time to get ready for one opponent. You have to make sure you don't put too much on your players' plate in terms of what they need to do preparing mentally. You want them to still go out there, play fast, play aggressive, and now they're leading into this week, and they believe Tom Brady's experience, this team's experience, about half this team has played on at least two Super Bowls with the Patriots, can get them ready and get them through that preparation side as they get ready for Sunday. Now let's head up the road to Tom Pelissero and the Rams.
James, I'm about 8 miles north of you in the Buckhead District where the Rams checked into their hotel last night. They'll kick off their Super Bowl week with meetings here at the hotel today. Then they'll head up to their temporary headquarters, which is the Atlanta Falcons facility, 40 miles to the northeast of here. The players will get a lift in there. Then they'll head downtown for media night at State Farm Arena where the Rams are first up at the podium, a little after 7 p.m. Now, you mentioned the experience factor. Tom Brady's been to 8 Super Bowls. The entire Rams roster combined has been to 5. Sean McVay's trying to become the youngest head coach ever to win a Super Bowl. But I'll tell you this, in speaking to people who are on the plate here, this is a pretty loose and relaxed group, and not just because of those matching sweatsuits they all were wearing. They feel like they got a really good week of preparation last week out in California. Now it's all about trying to make this week as normal as possible. No on-field work for the Rams planned until Wednesday, okay?
Thanks so much to Tom and to James. They'll be joining us all week long with the Patriots and the Rams at their hotels, respectively, back here in New York City to kick off Super Bowl week. Let's talk about these squads, guys. The Pats, the Rams, they held send-off rallies in their hometowns, respectively, yesterday before traveling down to Atlanta for the Super Bowl. Let's take a listen and start in Foxborough, where Tom Brady pumped up a crowd that needed no pumping up because it was about 2 Madison Square Gardens, about 35,000 people in Foxborough.
We're excited. I hope you guys are excited. And as Des said, let's let them hear it all the way down in Atlanta. We're still here. We're still here. We're still here. We're still here. We're still here.
I didn't even notice that.
That's amazing.
Kyle.
Thanos was there. Someone had the gauntlet with the Infinity Stone.
There.
It's still there.
I'll hit the Rams with the watch out.
Look at her 6th ring on that arm. All right. Lately, we've seen a rejuvenated, sort of different, fun, more vocal, more verbose Tom Brady. Normally, I feel like he's more reserved, all business, going into these sort of situations. We've even seen clips of Julian Edelman screaming, "You're too old!" Tom Brady to get him revved up on the sideline. And Brady's made sarcastic comments all the way through, starting in the postseason, saying, "Everybody thinks that we suck." So he's embracing this underdog mentality, whether it should be there or not. So it was a roaring crowd in Foxborough. What do you guys think of that reaction and that scene up in Foxy Town?
And this comes after Brady has come out and said that there's no way that he's walking away from the game. We all saw that interview. The energy, the passion, him being as vocal as he is just a reminder how much he loves the game. I mean, Brady loves football more than anybody loves anything else. I told you guys before that he has an insatiable appetite for success. All the games that he played, the records that he's broke, the Super Bowl rings, the victories, and still he's still passionate more than ever. I was trying to figure out how much he loves football.
Okay.
And I feel like he loves football more than Miss Piggy loves Kermit.
That's a lot.
She's a lot. She's all over Kermit. More than Cookie Monster loves Cookie. More than Schrager loves iced coffee. Okay. That's Brady in football. So for me, that passion that he brings, he's talking to the crowd, of course, but he's talking to his teammates.
Mm-hmm.
And they listen when Brady talks. And they're going to approach this the right way, reminding each other there's a reason why we're still here, because we're the best team in football.
Does anyone on the Patriots, a player, a step, does anyone roll their eyes?
At Brady?
Does anyone just be like, duh?
McCourty was giggling in the background a little bit.
Does anyone roll their eyes?
On the team?
The nobody believed in us Patriots of 2019 might be the most insufferable thing we've dealt with in the NFL in years. That nobody believes in us. They were favored for 67 straight games. They were underdogs in one game in Kansas City in a late afternoon game in hostile environment.
Wait, 67?
67 straight weeks. And they were underdogs once. And now Brady's Rudy Ruttinger running out of the field. Like, let's go.
Brady. Let him play.
It's a lot. If you're not a Patriots fan and you're not bought in, it's a lot to take the nobody believed in us Patriots. And I'm coming off here looking like a cynic. Because you know what? It doesn't matter what we think.
Mm-hmm.
And when I ask if anyone from the Patriots staff or player are rolling their eyes, the answer is no. And like, they respond to this and Edelman buys in. And after all these years and all these Super Bowl appearances and all these victories, they still have found a way to motivate themselves and believe that nobody believes in us. Mm-hmm. And for that, there is a credit to be given to Brady, to Belichick, and whatever things they're saying in that building. Because the truth of the matter is, this wasn't us who created all this. Rob Gronkowski put on Instagram when Danny Amendola left, be free.
Yeah, be happy.
Be happy. Like, I didn't do that. I didn't say that to Amendola. Gronk
right.
did. And,
right.
and the FaceTime or the Facebook thing that Brady did, there were a lot of indications of maybe being unhappy with some things. Like, this wasn't something from the outside coming in and chirping at you. It was from the inside out. So Brady doing a mic drop and 35,000 people with Thanos hands and all this stuff, it's great and it's good for a week, but I do wonder if in their heart of hearts, someone there in New England is rolling their eyes and being like, are we serious?
Peter, I'm rolling my eyes at you, buddy, right now, because you're going, we didn't, and it should be here. How many times at this table and our last table and the studio before that have you constructed this whole thing that the empire's crumbling? I don't think it's all coming. I think they're talking about, and I don't mean to make it about you, because it's about everybody. And now that they're at the Super Bowl, I feel like tweets are being deleted, columns are being broken down. They lost the game to Pittsburgh, and the whole thing was eulogized. They don't have it, and Brady's too old, and Gronk's broken. They lost by one score at Heinz Field, finally, okay? And it was all, the Chargers are loaded. They destroyed the Chargers. It's Mahomes League now. Mahomes didn't have enough. I like it. And I think it is not based on nothing. I think people were ready for it to be dead, and it isn't. I also think angry Brady is a cool thing. I like it. You know, over the years, like, I remember he showed up the first one, and it was, golly gee, there's my sister in the crowd, and we're here. I remember very vividly the 18-0 year against the Giants. That was super arrogant, cocky Brady.
Ooh.
Because Plexico came out and made his final score predictions. I think we're going to win 23-17. And Brady's like, he thinks we're only going to score 17 points. What happened? They lost. Is also the last factor of the hate. People are sick of them. All right, I want to look at the newspaper today. Patriots, this is New York. We're still here, fans wish they were. This is Serby, the pretty boy quarterback. America's sick of the Patriots, and with good reason. It's too bad, because there's Alabama football, and there's Johnny Bananas, and there's Grey's Anatomy, and I don't care what, the Republican Party, whatever it is, certain things are there because they keep winning too bad.
Fun storyline going into this week, of course, and it's been fun to track over the past couple weeks, him being more vocal. I guess the question for me becomes, does it change how I think about the Patriots going into this matchup? Because it's very different from what they did last year, which is maybe learning lessons from those moments like against the Giants when he doesn't want to shake people's hands and he's saying
what
he said about Plex. And then he loses, that he maybe approaches these games a little differently. Against the Eagles, he was all business and quiet. This year, it's different. Does it make you feel like it's like he knows something? Like, if you're a Rams fan, you've seen pouty Brady, crying Brady, elated Brady, vengeance Brady. You've seen all the different kinds of Bradys. But the last one you want to see is confident Brady.
Yeah.
Right?
I don't think if he knew we got it, he wouldn't be standing in front of people saying we're still here. He's like, this team is loaded. We got this thing. You're right. Yeah.
We'll see how it shakes out. They're both in Atlanta for Super Bowl 53. We're breaking it down all week. We're headed there after the show tomorrow. This one's headed there tonight. He'll be pulling double duty on NFL Network. The Rams.
He's still
only
here.
Super Bowl victory.